Welcome, welcome. I recognize that we are, as people are coming, there's an opportunity to get your breakfast and to greet others, but we do need to be mindful of the time. So we're going to go ahead and begin our program. At this time, I would like to invite Nathan Schubert Estrada to provide a land acknowledgement.
My name is Nathan Schubert Estrada. I am a member of the Pascua-Yaqui tribe based out in southern Tucson. I am also Peneteca Comanche based out on the southern plains of Texas. So with that, Santa Larden, our land acknowledgement. We recognize that California State University, San Bernardino, sits on the territory ancestral and land of the Samoan Band of Mission Indians, also known as the Havatam. We recognize that every member of the California State University San Bernardino community has benefited and continues to benefit from the use and occupation of this land since the institution's founding in 1965. Consistent with our values of community and diversity, we have responsibility to acknowledge and make visible the university's relationship to Native peoples. By offering this land acknowledgement, we affirm indigenous sovereignty and will work to uphold California State University San Bernardino more accountable to the needs of American Indian and indigenous peoples. Thank you.
And we'd like to follow that with a labor acknowledgement. Dr. Angela Luke will bring us that.
In honor of Black history, we'd like to give a labor and life acknowledgement. We pay homage to those who were stolen from Africa, placed in bondage, falsely named as chattel, and forced into labor, who were called slaves, but never submitted as such, who have always been fully human, with an unbroken connection to the divine and to each other. We honor our African Americans, our ancestors, for the still unpaid labor which built what is now the Americas. To both our indigenous and African forebears, we commit to the continued struggle for liberation and reparations, for it is only through freedom and justice that we truly give honor. Thank you.
We have a very special group of guests with us this morning to bring us the Black National Anthem, the Voices of Unity. Will you please come?
Probably works a little better when you turn it on, huh? Good morning, everyone. You all look absolutely beautiful on this morning. So we're just gonna go before you with the Black National Anthem, known as Lift Every Voice, and we're just gonna all sing this first verse together. So we're gonna ask that if you wouldn't mind that you rise to your feet so that we can all sing this song together.
Every voice and sing till earth and heaven.
Have a round of applause once again for the voices of unity. A stirring rendition of the Black National Anthem. And now to welcome us on behalf of the campus, our very own president, Dr. Tomas Morales.
Thank you, Professor Irving. It is indeed my great pleasure to welcome you to our 11th Pioneer Breakfast Scholarship Celebration, a wonderful campus tradition I look forward to each February. Hosted by the Black Faculty, Staff, and Student Association, the Pioneer Breakfast honors the accomplishments of Black Americans who have made an impact at Cal State San Bernardino by demonstrating a passion for students, exemplifying a commitment to CSUSB, exhibiting professionalism, and exuding a positive attitude towards colleagues and the campus community, and I would also include the larger community of San Bernardino and Riverside counties, AKA the Inland Empire. This year's theme is a tapestry of time, celebrating our enduring legacy. Today's proceeds will go towards future scholarships for our current CSUSB students. Over the past decade, this event has awarded more than 400 scholarships and continues to be an inspiration to our current students and future generations we have yet to know. Please join me in applauding in advance all the students we will meet today. This event is also an opportunity to bring the campus and community together to highlight our Black scholar leaders and celebrate individuals who are making a difference. You will meet each of our outstanding awardees as the program continues for the Pioneer Staff Award, the Pioneer Administrator Award, the Pioneer Alumni Award, the Pioneer Faculty Award, the Lorraine Frost Ally Award, the Emerging Leader Award, and the Community Icon Award. Please note that our student scholars have the opportunity to research the accomplishment of this year's awardees. By doing so, they bridge the past with the present and create meaningful dialogue. As CSUSB's president, I'm proud to say that we are structurally committed to providing a diverse, equitable, and inclusive learning environment. We anticipate our students evolving into exceptional professionals, active leaders, and change makers for their community. Today, we applaud all that they are and will become. Within the university, as we see change, we know there is still critical work that needs to be done in supporting our Black students, faculty, and staff. The CSU Chancellor's Office released recently the Black Student Success Report for the CSUs with 13 critical areas of emphasis. Through the findings of this report, CSUSB has created the Office of Black Student Success with a director position and additional key staff positions for the office. The campus has also created a Black Student Success Steering Committee with key stakeholders from our campus to ensure areas of emphasis for Black student success are implemented. This organization, this structural organization, joins the already very successful and engaged Pan-African Student Center. While these new initiatives move forward, know that Black students at CSUSB are fully involved, an engaged part of our university community, active in every aspect of campus life, such as participating in a wide-ranging student clubs and organizations, innovating in musical and theater events, joining in our many athletic programs, serving as student employees, filling roles that help them gain professional experience, and volunteering for service efforts. So we continue to build and support our diverse campus to ensure that it grows more inclusive each year. I wish to express my particular thanks to this year's Pioneer Breakfast Planning Committee for preparing for and overseeing all the hundreds of details which going into making an event like today happen. Your efforts are greatly appreciated. Once again, congratulations to this year's honorees and scholarship awardees. And my thanks to all of you for attending today's scholarship event and joining in this celebration, honoring all those who have had or will be having in the future, thanks to your scholarship support, a lasting impact here at CSUSB and throughout the Inland Empire. Thank you.
And at this time, we would like to announce those scholarship awardees. Sherika Bell and Veronica Ramirez Emerson will come to present those awards. Good morning. Happy Black History Month. Thank you. Before we begin with the student awardees, the Pioneer Breakfast Committee and just our campus overall would like to take a moment to recognize the families of our scholarship honorees. These honorees have been pioneers for this event, and the scholarships have been able to be given to our students every year. So we want to thank the families. If you are here representing the families of our honorees, we would love for you to stand to be able to be recognized. So first, receiving the Dr. Mildred Henry Scholarship is Prashant Gokhale. Next, receiving the John Overton Scholarship is Chanel Jones. Receiving the Belva Holder Scholarship is Anita Ntiasigwe. Thank you.
Receiving the Tara Lynn Monet Scholarship is Diamond Griffin. Up next, receiving the Dr. Jean Peacock and Walter Hawkins Scholarship is Kudakwashe Magwenzi. Receiving the Felix Family Scholarship is Ryan Moremi. Before we bring up our last awardee, I'd like to call Dr. Robert Nava to the podium to present the last awardee.
Good morning, everyone. And thank you. I have the pleasure this morning of announcing two additional scholarships that will be directed to our African-American students on this campus. I'm Robert Nava, and I have the privilege of serving as the Vice President for University Advancement. And to our colleagues on campus, to our elected officials, the pastors who are here with us today, community, we just want to say how important our relationship and partnership with the African-American community in Cal State San Bernardino is. You know, with the leadership of President Morales and our deans and our provost, you know, we continue to focus on engaging and addressing the needs of our African-American students, but also other underserved students. And part of that process, it's not enough just to engage and recruit students to come to Cal State San Bernardino, because once the student arrives on this campus, then we have a responsibility to ensure that the student has the resources that she needs, has the academic tutoring and mentorship that he needs so that they can be successful and so that they can also graduate and go on and help change the world. You know, 2 years ago, we lost an incredible champion and alumna of Cal State San Bernardino and the Inland Empire, the community. Many of us knew and worked with and loved Mrs. Lois Carson. And when we think about the legacy that Mrs. Carson, her legacy of addressing opportunities for all communities, but with a special love and focus for the African-American community. Mrs. Carson, when I had the privilege of working with her, she served on the CSUSB Foundation Board until she was 90. She served actively until the last week of her passing. That was how committed she was to the work in generating resources. But today, colleagues, I want to share with you that with the support of the National Council of Negro Women and other community members, the Alumni Association, the foundation is establishing the Lois Carson Scholarship to support African American students. What do you think? You know, Lois's spirit is here with us today. Her spirit, her work, her legacy. And I was thinking also as I had the pleasure of saying hello to Mary Jane McCoy, Mrs. McCoy, yes. I want to share with you, colleagues, just to make sure that our students also know that Mrs. Carson was a pioneer She was a trailblazer. She opened up opportunities, not just for members of the Black community, but for the Latino community, for the underserved community to have access to higher education. And Mrs. McCoy, if you allow me, I also want to say that Mrs. McCoy, an alumna, class of 67, was also part of the first class of African American students that came to Cal State San Bernardino. Last Friday night, we had the privilege and honor of recognizing Mrs. McCoy for her work in higher education as a principal, working in K-12 to continue to provide that access for students. And Mrs. McCoy received a very special honor from the College of Social and Behavioral Sciences as the Paw Print Alumna of the Year for the college. So, Mrs. McCoy. Finally, I'm gonna finish very quickly. Thank you, Veronica, for giving me this moment, because the scholarships that were awarded to our students today make a big difference in their success. But I also want to share with you that with President Morales, the provost, the deans, we continue to raise funds, scholarship funds, to support our students, to support programs, to support our faculty. We are engaged in a $200 million campaign, and we are having tremendous success in engaging our alumni and friends of the university. But it's important that we continue to raise scholarship funds for our students so that they can be successful. And as President Morales has said, we also want to raise scholarship funds so our students can travel internationally, study abroad, as we did last summer when we had students that went to South Africa, right? And friends, I'm going to ask you, please consider your support to the scholarship, whether it's to our alumni association or the colleges or the foundation. And finally, I'm going to make one more big announcement, and this is hot off the press, also, as they say. With President Morales' support, we were very fortunate that the vice chair of the CSU trustees, Mr. Jack Clark Jr., and his wife Sheila, have established an endowed scholarship to support African American students on our campus. Yes? Yeah. Yeah, give it up, come on. I'm going to tell you one last item, and then I'm going to get off the stage. But Jack Clark Jr., vice chair of the trustees, very prominent lawyer in Riverside. But I also want you to know that Jack's father, Jack Clark Sr., was the first African American to serve on the city council in Riverside. And Jack Clark Sr. opened those doors, as his son, Jack Clark Jr., and his wife, Sheila, continue to do. And we will be awarding the Sheila and Jack Clark Jr. scholarship later this spring, and we'll be celebrating them in future Pioneer events. So with that, thank you very much, and enjoy. And this Sunday is Super Sunday. Pastors, we're going to be out at the churches on Sunday, at the Black churches on Sunday, carrying the message of higher education. We want our students to come to Cal State San Bernardino. We want them to finish that FAFSA form, and we want those students here to be successful. So thank you.
And lastly, receiving the Lois Carson scholarship is Autumn Hudson. Give all of our current recipients so far another round of applause, everyone. Good
morning. My name is Veronica Ramirez Emerson. I'm the proud director of the Educational Opportunity Program and Renaissance Scholars Program here at CSUSB. And I always look forward to this event every year because not only do I get to see old friends, old colleagues, but also a number of EOP alumni. So thank you for being here and joining us this morning. I have the honor this morning to announce the 2024 recipients of the Friends of John Fudge Scholarship Award. This scholarship was established in 2007, and it was with the support of many of John's friends, family, and colleagues throughout our campus and the community. His legacy is going to continue to be recognized because of the work not only that he did here and the instrumental part that he had in establishing the first SMSU, and I'm sure he would love to have seen the opening also of this beautiful SMSU building. And we miss him dearly. I know that he's here with us in spirit because when I was approached by John many years ago and asked to see the scholarship through, I was super excited because John and I shared very similar values. And one of the things that I could always count on him, because he was an active EOP alumni chapter, and when he could make it, he could make it, because if you knew John, he was involved in everything. But I knew, like many other EOP alumni, if I called his phone, he would pick up, and he asked how he could help. And whether that was extending an opportunity for a student or showing up. That's one thing that I was always grateful for. And I want to take a moment, because don't think I didn't notice that they didn't stand up. I want to recognize John's family who's with us today. So Terry, Stan, Lois, and Marcus, along with their spouses, if you could please stand up. For those of you that knew John, one of the most beautiful characteristics that he had was the fact that he loved to embrace and celebrate many cultures and identities. And that was one of the beautiful characteristics of John. So it brings me great pleasure to not only have John's family here with us today and say thank you for your ongoing support of CSUSB and our EOP program throughout the years, but we want to make sure that our students here that are receiving this opportunity are recognized, because one thing that John was always interested in is the fact that students who receive this award, not only are students that are in need, but students who have a multicultural interest and demonstrate awareness of global citizenship. And so it brings me great honor to invite up, we have five recipients this year. Two, thank you. Two are with us this morning, so I want to start off by recognizing our first recipient. If I can have Miss Alexis Sullivan, please join me on the stage. Before I invite up our recipient who was able to join us today, I also want to recognize the three students that are not here with us today, Dimo Salik, Kelly Armstrong, and Jamar Barnes. So let's give them a round of applause. And our second recipient of the John Fudge Scholarship Award is Ms. Kenya Doxey. Kenya? Thank you.
Thank you. Can we have a round of applause for all of the scholarship awardees? The saying is that 1 ounce of truth benefits like ripples in a pond. You heard that one? Right? How many of you can remember that time that auntie or grandpa or uncle somebody put a little money in your hand and said, shh, that's for you.
right? That's what the scholarships do. I'd like to encourage you to donate to the Black Faculty and Staff Association scholarships, to be a part of the inspiration, honor, legacy, and celebration. At this time, we'd like to move into the Pioneer Awards. I'd like to ask all the previous awardees if you could stand where you are so we can acknowledge them. It's great to have you with us. We're going to begin with our alumni honoree, and I'm going to invite Jordan Johnson to come and provide the introduction.
Hello, everyone. Happy Black History Month. Just to break the ice by saying it's 100% not COVID. Just a strep throat, but I don't want my other colleagues to get it. But my name is Jordan Johnson, and I'm a first year student here at Cal State San Bernardino. I'm currently majoring in design and marketing, and I currently work at the Pan-African Student Success Center. Today, I will be introducing Assemblymember Dr. Corey A. Jackson. Dr. Jackson was elected to the California State Assembly in November of 2022. He represents the 60th Assembly District. In 2023, he chaired the Human Services Assembly District. In 2023, he chaired the Human Services Committee and currently serves as the chair of Budget Subcommittee Number 2 on Human Services. Dr. Jackson served on the Riverside County Board of Education in 2020 and represented portions of the cities in Riverside, Moreno Valley, Paris, and the unincorporated community of Med Valley. He also serves as the founder and chief executive officer of the SBX Youth and Family Services, whose mission is to break the cycle of poverty and violence through mentoring, education, and community organizations. The organization was instrumental in the historic settlement of a lawsuit against the unconstitutional youth accountability team program in Riverside County that treated thousands of youth, especially those of color, like criminals for minor adolescent misbehaviors. The county agreed on groundbreaking measures. Dr. Jackson graduated from CSUS San Bernardino, where he received his degree in political science and served as a member of the CSU Board of Trustees and chairs of the Santos Manuel Student Union Board of Directors. He is also a graduate of California Baptist University, where he received his Master of Social Work degree and Doctor of Social Work degree. Please welcome Dr. Corey Jackson.
He did a good job, right? They wouldn't let me near a mic when I was a freshman. It is indeed my honor to be here with family, with the community that raised me. I am deeply humbled to have received the Alumni Award at this year's Pioneer Breakfast. I want to thank President Robertson and the Black Faculty, Staff, and Student Association for the recognition and all the hard work they have put in to ensuring the success of generations of leaders and cultivating a welcoming environment for students on campus. The scholarships being awarded today are truly a commitment and an investment in our students and the future of our community. And I'm immensely grateful for the education and opportunities that I've received during my time here. And next year, I will be a contributor to the scholarships for next year. I need you to know that this institution helped to transform my life.
as just a, I left my glasses at home, but as a little nerdy black boy from Rialto, coming to Cal State San Bernardino, the enrollment day that was here on campus was the first day I ever stepped foot on a college campus. But also, let me be clear, I was a remedial education student. Let me be clear, it took me 6 years to graduate. But I still got that doctorate. So I want to thank the professors and the mentors, many of which have scholarships named after them. Walter Hawkins was my personal mentor assigned to me. John Fudge was somebody that as soon as I got on campus, he said, hey, let me show you how this place works. He's the one that told me to apply to be on the Student Union Board of Directors that I ended up chairing. He's the one that encouraged me to apply to be a member of the CSU Board of Trustees, appointed by Arnold Schwarzenegger at the time. And from time to time, and if you know Walter Hawkins, he'll always tell you like it is, whether you like it or not. And so from time to time, I didn't act right. I got my lashing from him. And then when I got back to Rialto, Mayor Robertson gave me another lashing. But the idea is this, I was raised by a village. And there is never a moment of my time growing up in the Inland Empire that I cannot specifically point to a specific person in the village that set me on the path that I'm on today. And so I just want to say thank you to many of you who are in this room. But I also want to expressly say one thing that I don't think we realize, that the first ever black assembly member was Wilmer Carter in the Inland Empire, an alumni of Cal State San Bernardino. And I'm the first African American elected to the legislature from Riverside County. And the first openly LGBTQ African-American elected in California's history to the legislature. There is something about the students that this university pumps out. And I'm gonna tell you what it is. We pump out people who are workhorses and not show horses. Or maybe I should say coyotes. And just like a coyote, you will never really see them amongst a lot of people, but they will be behind the scenes doing the dirty work. And often doing and going places that most people are not willing to do. So when communities are looking for people to solve some of the toughest issues pressing our communities, pressing the African-American community, it is usually a coyote that they come to ask to step up. Okay. We should be proud of the people that we pump out of this university. And then lastly, let me just say a little bit about reparations. This year, the Legislative Black Caucus introduced its inaugural four pieces of legislation. to begin the sacred journey of getting reparations for our people. And this year will certainly begin to lay the foundation for what is to come. Now, one of the things that we must do is, I know many are going to be asking, where's my check? But I also need you to understand this, if you've been following the research, that those of you who have made it to the upper middle class of this society, you've been able to purchase a home. You've been able to make sure your students, your children, do not grow up in poverty. All the data continues to show that today, in today's policy environment, today's systemic environment, the likelihood that your children will continue on that path is still slim. Our black children are still more likely to fall back into poverty instead of continuing to build economic wealth for future generations. So there's still a lot of systemic things that must be done so that when we are able to get those checks, that it doesn't just benefit one generation, but multiple generations, and that it will benefit people long after that any of us will be on this earth. So I ask you to be a part of that journey. I ask you to speak up, and I ask you to stay engaged. It's my honor to be here with you all. Thank you.
Next award, the Emerging Leader Award, I'd like to invite Autumn Hudson.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
You all look so beautiful today. My name is actually Ayanna McAllister. I will be the one handing out the Emerging Leader Award. So I am a third year biology pre-med major here at Cal State San Bernardino. Thank you. And I also work as a student pre-health advisor here at the Health Professions Advising Center. Finally, I am the Director of Recruitment for the Medical and Pre-Health Student Society here on campus. Today, I have the absolute honor of introducing Cassandra Butcher. Cassandra Butcher is a distinguished and passionate professional in the field of higher education and mental health. She is honored to be named a recipient of the 2024 Emerging Leader Award. Graduating with distinction in spring 2017, her journey as a student was marked by her unwavering commitment to campus engagement. During her undergraduate years, she served as a dedicated student assistant, orchestrating countless programs for the student union that left a lasting impact on the e-campus community. Her enthusiasm for fostering a positive and inclusive campus culture extended to her roles as a resident assistant and hall coordinator in Residence Life, where she played a pivotal role in creating a supportive living environment for her fellow students. Additionally, Cassandra embraced the responsibility of being an orientation leader, warmly welcoming new students and helping them acclimate to university life. Notably, She also played a key role in the establishment of the Pan-African Student Success Center, as we see today, a testament to her commitment to diversity and inclusion. Upon her graduation, Cassandra Poole pursued her passion for higher education, earning a Master's of Education in Higher Education from the University of Houston. Her professional journey led her to the University of California, Riverside, where she made significant contributions to student success initiatives. While currently working within the residential life at UCLA, Cassandra is also furthering her education at California Baptist University, working towards obtaining her license as a marriage and family therapist. Simultaneously, she runs a thriving self-care and wellness business. Through her business, she hosts transformative retreats, provides one-on-one mentorship, departmental wellness training sessions, and facilitates empowering workshops and events for the community. Cassandra's multifaceted career exemplifies her dedication to a holistic student development, mental health advocacy, and community well-being. The Emerging Leader Award is a well-deserved recognition of her outstanding contributions and serves as a testament to her continuous impact on the fields of education and mental health. Please join me in welcoming our Emerging Leader, Cassandra Butcher.
Good morning, everyone. Can y'all hear me? Good morning, good morning. Wow, that was a beautiful introduction. I don't know where she went. Thank you. I was sitting there like, that's me? I did that? I did. Praise God. Not every college student gets the opportunity to find a mentor that they know will sow into them for the next 4 years. There's no guarantee that you'll build friendships with people who want to support you personally, professionally, and academically. You don't easily come across people who want to clear the road to help you excel academically. And it's rare, I mean very rare, that you will find an on-campus job, not one, but two, filled with staff that will swiftly embrace you and take you under their wing because they want to see you succeed, not just in college, but also in life. That was my experience here as a student at Cal State San Bernardino. I was blessed enough to walk this campus and accomplish almost every dream or goal that I had while I was here. I was able to share my vision with people who wanted to enhance it. I was able to overcome my first generation fears of not being good enough or smart enough. Whether it was through creating fun and educational programs in Res Life, hosting hundreds of events through the Cross Cultural Center, being an orientation leader, serving on the board for ASI, being a part of BSU or SAS, hiring my peers to work with me because our friends need jobs, and if you got the power to do it, you're gonna plug them. Bringing our diverse student body together. Oh, we can't forget, as she mentioned earlier, playing a key role in establishing several cultural centers for students today to walk into and feel like they are at home. These are the experiences and the memories that I don't take lightly. These are the experiences that led me here today. But of course, I couldn't have done this by myself. I was blessed with a supportive village during my time at CSUSB. And I believe that my growth and my leadership experience is a reflection of being able to find several staff members who believed in me. They didn't just see another student when they saw me. They also saw a God-given light. And most importantly, they saw that light on the days that I didn't see it myself and didn't hesitate to remind me of the bright future ahead of me. I am deeply honored and extremely humbled to be selected as a recipient of the 2024 Emerging Leader Award by the Black Faculty, Staff, and Student Association. As a proud spring 2017 graduate, this recognition holds a special place in my heart. This award, this recognition, is a reflection of my Cal State San Bernardino village. I am truly grateful for the opportunity to continue contributing to the growth and the well-being of the students here at Cal State San Bernardino. And I look forward to continuing this journey of leadership and service. To the Black faculty, staff, student association, to my CSUSB village, I just want to say thank you for this incredible honor.
To present our next award to the community icon, Taylor Coulter.
Good morning. Sorry I had to move so slow. I had to waddle up here. My name is Taylor Coulter. I am an ethnic studies major with a concentration in African American studies here at CSUSB. Thank you. I am also the lead student assistant in the Pan-African Student Success Center upstairs on the third floor, and it's an honor to be here with you today. I would like to ask you to join me in welcoming our community icon awardee, Patricia L. Nichols Butler. She sounds amazing. Patricia has a long-standing and distinguished career encompassing both public and private sectors. As a native of San Bernardino, California, Patricia has served as the CEO of Community Action Partnership since 1992. As CEO, Patricia is responsible for overseeing one of the largest nonprofit agencies in the county of San Bernardino with an annual budget of $44.7 million and a staff of over 137 employees. In addition to her work with Community Action Partnership, Patricia is involved in numerous professional and community activities. Ms. Nichols Butler currently serves on the Dignity Health Designated Procedures Oversight Committee and serves as the first VP of the State Association of California Community Action Partnership. She served as the vice chair of the San Bernardino County Interagency Council on Homelessness, a board member of the Girl Scouts of San Gorgonio Council, secretary of the California Association of Food Banks, and San Bernardino Valley College Foundation, and a founding member of the San Bernardino County Association of African American Employees. Like I said, she's done a lot. She sounds amazing. Ms. Nichols Butler was the recipient of the 2023 Lois Carson Leadership Award from California Community Action Partnership Association and the 2022 Woman of the Year Award for the 40th California Assembly District. Patricia is credited with transitioning Community Action Partnership from a public entity under the County of San Bernardino to a private nonprofit corporation in 2003. The agency's history is rooted in a commitment to eradicating poverty and enhancing the overall well-being of its residents. As a trusted community partner since 1965, Community Action Partnership has not only adapted to changing needs of the San Bernardino County population, but has also been a catalyst for a positive transformation. Through collaborative efforts and a steadfast commitment to its mission, Community Action Partnership continues to make a significant impact in the lives of those facing economic challenges, particularly in the crucial area of hunger relief, emergency assistance, and energy conservation. Community Action Partnership has forged a long-standing partnership with CSUSB. For many years, Community Action Partnership has partnered with CSUSB's Institute for Child Development and Family Relations to coordinate data entry and written analyses of the agency community needs assessment. In addition, they partner with CSUSB's Child Development Basic Needs and Student Support Department to support Campus Cupboard Program to provide vital resources and encourage students to remain in school and achieve their academic goals. CSUSB continues to be a valued partner of Community Action Partnership, and the university's continued support extends to collaborating with the food bank to host food packaging parties. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Patricia L. Nichols Butler.
Well, thank you. I had two thoughts as I was coming up here. One was Corey Jackson, Assemblymember Corey Jackson. I said, well, he probably gets more than 3 minutes to speak. I'm not going to address that. And the other thought I had, the emerging leader comes up with her phone, and I walk up with a piece of paper. So the old guard, the new guard. Thank you for honoring me. It is a privilege to be here this morning. So good morning, everyone. Esteemed members of the state of California, I'm sorry, esteemed members of the California State University of San Bernardino, Blacks, faculty and staff, and Student Association, thank you from the depths of my heart for bestowing this incredible award on me. I am deeply grateful to follow so many prominent individuals who have received this award, the Community Icon Award. Individuals such as Lois J. Carson and Dr. Margaret Hill, both are beloved individuals and hold a special place in my heart. Also on my board, another individual, Mayor Deborah Robertson. So definitely I follow some very prestigious individuals. As indicated, I've served as the CEO of Community Action Partnership for the last 37 years, but my story does not end there. I've actually been a part of this organization this year, 50 years. As a nonprofit organization that is meeting the most crucial needs of our most vulnerable population, I am proud of the work that we do each and every day. For over 59 years, as an organization who is deeply rooted in the mission to eradicate poverty, to help individuals become self-reliant and economically stable, we do amazing work, and I'm proud of that work. In terms of the level of work we do, it's amazing. We partner with over 250 organizations to provide support to our community. And that work could not be done without the dedication of a number of individuals, many of whom are here today. I have an outstanding, committed board of directors, a leadership team, and staff who have the passion, the commitment, the dedication to forge what is needed to keep this organization going. Next year, we will celebrate 60 years of the War on Poverty movement. And I accept this award as a representative of the collective efforts and collaborations of our board of directors, our leadership team, and our staff. None of our accomplishments would be possible without them. I have dedicated my life to helping others, and this award makes me ever mindful of our continued responsibility to encourage and support each other and build bridges for future generations. I extend my sincere gratitude to the Black faculty staff and Student Association for their dedication to fostering an inclusive and supportive environment at Cal State San Bernardino. Your work, your tireless work, is the cornerstone of positive change, and I'm honored to be recognized among such distinguished individuals. I thank God every day for his goodness and his blessings. I especially want to acknowledge the individuals who lift me up, hold me up, prop me up, and stand behind me in the work that I've done over these many years. They too are here today. So I want to say thank you to my beautiful daughter, my son-in-law, and my grandson, who surprised me by being here. My amazing sisters, who traveled a far distance to be here on this early Friday morning, and my brother-in-law, and my friends, all who continue to support me. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you again for this remarkable award. I'm truly honored, and I'm humbled, and may God richly bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Hear from the voices of unity.
I want to first say before we get into this song that it is such a tremendous honor and a blessing and a beautiful sight to see being involved and witnessing this type of celebration, this type of honoring, this type of a platform and event where so much greatness is being celebrated and encouraged and motivated. It's beautiful to be a part of that. So I want to thank you all for allowing us just to be a part of this. We're going to sing a quick song by, I think, amazing black man who's made great strides in the music community and encouraging us, allowing us to feel so many different feelings, but kind of pioneering some beautiful and major moments, one of which when Barack Obama was campaigning to become the first black president of the United States of America. And this song that we're about to perform for you was the leading song for that campaign. And I think it kind of speaks to just the continuance of black and people of color moving in excellence. So we hope this encourages you.
If you hear this message, wherever you stand, calling every woman, calling every man, we're the generation, we can't afford to wait. The future started yesterday, and we're already late. We've been looking for a song to sing. We searched for a melody, searched for someone to lead. We've been looking for the world to change. We can be heroes. Go on and say if you're out there. Sing along with me if you're out there. I'm dying to believe that you're out there. Stand up and say loud. Broken promises and no more calls to war, unless it's love and peace that we're really fighting for. We can destroy hunger and we can conquer.
God bless you all. We are Voices of Unity.
A delight to have with us. And now we're going to move to our Pioneer Awardees for this year to introduce our staff honoree, Autumn Hudson.
Adjust that a little bit. Good morning, everyone. My name is Autumn Hudson, and I am a third-year environmental health science pre-law major with a minor in political science. Currently, I am the Associated Students Incorporated, or ASI, Vice President of Finance. I'm also the chapter president of the Epsilon Sigma chapter of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated. And last but not least, I am a member of the Pre-Law Society. And today I have the honor of introducing one of our pioneers, Ms. Denise D. Bowen. Ms. Bowen entered into the technology field in 1970, initiating her career at International Business Machine, or IBM. It was there that she applied her skills to diverse business application programs. Overcoming challenges as a Black woman in the technology field, she worked twice as hard to achieve her success. Joining CSUSB in 2002, she contributed her expertise across departments doing a multitude of things such as equipment systems specialist in the data center and professional development assistant in the academic computing and media department. She was also an information technology consultant in the information technology services. Ms. D. Bowen emphasizes the vital role of excellent customer service in ensuring client satisfaction, building trust, and fostering enduring relationships. Please give a warm round of applause as we welcome to the stage our pioneer, Ms. Denise D. Bowen.
Oh, what a blessing. I'm really speechless. For you all that know me, you're probably like, I don't think so. First of all, I'd like to thank my daughter, my grandson, my son Donald, and my nephew Dimitri, and all my friends and the campus community for being here today. I'm just so honored. Unbelievable. Ooh. I got a call from Brother Roberson, and he said, "Sister," I said, "I know that's Roberson." He said, "Sister, we wanna honor you at the Pioneer Breakfast," and I said, "Why? What have I done? I don't know." So he said, "Well, you done this, you know." I said, "Okay, Anthony, I'll show up." But much love to you, Anthony. Yeah. I've always had passion for helping others, letting the students know that I care, and I was always there for them. If they were stressed, they could talk to me. If they were hungry, I'd feed them. If they were looking for work on campus, I'll find out who has the jobs. If they couldn't afford a cap and gown at graduation, I would purchase it. Those things I've done are just from my heart, and I care. I would like to leave you with a quote by Maya Angelou. My favorite quote is that I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. Thank you.
Introduce our next award, the Administrator Honoree, Jelanis Taylor.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jelanis Taylor. I am a first-year student here at CSUSB. I'm a theater arts major with a concentration in acting. Thank you. I'm also a member of the Student African-American Brotherhood, and I'm also a student assistant for the Department of Psychology. And today, I have the honor of introducing Del T. West. Del West grew up in Chicago, Illinois, and attended Andrews University in Michigan, where upon graduation with a BS degree in business administration, he joined Ford Motor Company as a labor relations representative, thus beginning a 40-year career in human resources. During his career, he worked in manufacturing, hospitality, banking, and higher education. Mr. West took the position of personnel officer at California State University, San Bernardino, after about 1 year in personnel at California State University, Fullerton. During his 28 years at CSUSB, Mr. West served as personnel officer, director of human resources, and finally as assistant vice president for human resources with responsibility for all aspects of HR administration. Also during this time, he held the additional title of Affirmative Action Officer with responsibility for EEO compliance. In 1986, Mr. West was a member of a broadly represented campus committee, which developed a unique sexual harassment prevention policy, the model of which was recently adopted by the United States military. That deserves clap. Mr. West retired from CSUSB in 2012 after 30 years of service to the CSU system. I now bring to the stage Del T. West.
Morning. It's truly an honor to be here this morning to receive this honor from the Black Faculty and Staff Association. As was mentioned, I had a 40-year career in human resources. And I'd like to acknowledge my wife, Dorita, who is here, my son, DeLauren, and my wife's support through 40 years of my profession. As was mentioned, I came to CSUSB from Cal State Fullerton, and Cal State Fullerton was my introduction to the CSU. I also worked in private industry before I came into the public sector and higher education. And there's a big difference between the private sector and higher education. In the private sector, the motivation is tremendously different. The private sector, a product or a service is developed and marketed, and the motivation is to make a profit in the private sector. Higher education is very different. Students come to a university or a college to receive education, to receive learning, and have value added to their lives. Within any organization, the success of an organization is dependent upon the people within that organization. Having been in human resources for so many years, I interviewed multiple hundreds of people, and the goal was always the same. Bring in the most talented people you can and help them succeed in their positions. I had an applicant once tell me that, you know, I've applied here 3 or 4 times, and it's hard to get into this place. And I thought to myself, there's a reason for that. When you look at Cal State San Bernardino, Cal State San Bernardino is a special place within the Inland Empire. It has a special mission here at this university. So therefore, when I was here, the goal was to hire special people to contribute to that mission. One of the two questions that I always asked an applicant was, what do you perceive the mission of this university to be? And clearly they would say, to educate students. I said, no, that's very good. My next question would be, well, how do you perceive this position to contribute to that mission of the university? And I'd get a variety of different answers. But you know, every position here at the university makes a contribution to the mission. There are no surplus positions here. Every position contributes to that mission, whether it's the classroom, the buildings, the grounds, the various divisions of the university, all moving forward to contribute to that mission, to educate students, to provide value added to individuals so they can leave this university, as was mentioned, and go out and make a contribution to their selected discipline or field. So it's been 12 years since I retired. Many of the individuals that I worked with have retired as well. So we may be gone from Cal State San Bernardino, but the mission endures. Thank you again for this honor today.
The faculty honoree, and to introduce our awardee, Laura Moorhead.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Laura Moorhead, and I am a third year here student majoring in psychology with a minor in criminal justice. I am a scheduling assistant. I am a scheduling assistant for the Santos Manuel Student Union, and I am the treasurer for Slam Tennis Club here at CSUSB. I have the honor of presenting Audrey Matthews. Matthews was a professor emerita at California State University of San Bernardino. who's dedicated more than 35 years to public service in local and state governments as a professor, budget director, and planning commissioner. She has also served as a member of San Bernardino County Planning Commissions and was a member of the San Bernardino Workforce Investment Board. An American Society for Public Administration member since 1977, Matthews was a life member and a longtime member of multiple sections, including the section for women in public administrations, where she served as the first editor of SWPS newsletter, Bridging the Gap, as the conference Minority Public Administration, which she chaired in the mid-1990s. Matthews' career began with the Chicago Police Department, after which she had moved to Beverly Hills and served as a payroll clerk. She went on and became a budget director for Beverly Hills, served in Compton, and after earning her MPA and DPA, moved to Washington, D.C. to become director of budget operations under Mayor Marion Barry. Matthews taught full-time at California State San Bernardino's College of Business and Public Administration between the years of 1966 and 2006. Developing curriculum on diversity management, economic development, and budget and finance, she was also the CEO of Matthews and Associates, her consulting firm in Los Angeles. When asked to describe her philosophy of service, Matthews states, "I have dedicated my life to helping those in need in the communities where I live, work, and play. Never thinking my life dedication to public service as something remarkable. I'm just doing what I was born to do, mentor, and provide a helping hand to those in need." Although Audrey Matthews has passed, we wanted to recognize and award Audrey Matthews for all of her achievements. Thank you.
We will be sending the award to Dr. Matthews' family. I know many of you will remember her excellent service to the campus community and the Inland Empire. Our next award is the Lorraine Frost Award, and this is a very important award that acknowledges an ally, the ally of allies on campus. And to present that award is Vinaya Jenkins.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is Vinaya Jenkins. I am a fourth year student studying business administration with a concentration in entrepreneurship and minoring in accounting. Thank you. In addition to being a full-time student, I am also the student lead of the Cross Cultural Center, the events coordinator of our Black Student Union, and the president of the Slam Tennis Club. Today, I have been given the honor of introducing Marielena Najera Nari. Mrs. Marielena Najera Nari started her career in the accounting department in CSUSB in February 1997. She has provided 27 years of service to this campus. Her first 11 years working for the university and her last 16 years working for the Santos Manuel Student Union. She is a first-generation student and alumnus of CSUSB. She graduated with her undergraduate degree with a Bachelor's of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in Accounting, and also received her Master's degree in Public Administration from CSUSB in 2017. She began contributing her services to BFSSA back in 2013, helping with getting bills paid, doing bank deposits, and providing financial information. She's a person who works behind the scenes and enjoys giving back to her community. She is involved in various activities with her church, such as being the church treasurer and directing a youth group. Her biggest motivation is providing and promoting higher education and guidance to first-generation students. Now please help me in welcoming Mrs. Marielena to the stage.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you. I'm just like Dee said, when Anthony came over and saw me and told me that I was going to be the recipient of this award, I was very honored. I still feel what I do is a very small thing for the organization, but I really do it with love, and I enjoy doing it. When Anthony asked, or I started my service with Aaron Burgess, helping him out, and then through the years with Anthony as well. And I'm just very, very thankful to the Lord, first of all, for his many blessings. And I just want to say that it's a very small, it's a very small contribution on my part, but I encourage all of us to always be, you know, to help our community in whichever way we can, you know, by providing funds for scholarships, that it's very important, but also our time and our service. If we're here on campus, you know, be part of our community and give back to our community. And I want to thank everybody who thought about me, and thank you so much. And I appreciate my family. My parents are here. And I want to just thank everybody. And the journey that I've had here on campus has been great. Listening to Mr. Del West, you know, that is our purpose. Whatever we do, our purpose is here to serve our students and to make, you know, make them a better person, to put our little grain of salt in whatever we do so that they can be transformed and give back to their community. Once again, thank you, everybody, and I am so honored to receive this.
Congratulations to all the awardees. Would the members of the Black Faculty, Staff, and Student Association Pioneer Breakfast Planning Committee please stand if you're in the room? If you're at the back of the room, will you give us a wave? Could we please acknowledge the enormous amount of work that went into this event? Extraordinary. If you are a current or past member of the Black Faculty, Staff, and Student Association, will you please stand and be recognized? Thank you all so much once again for your presence here, for uplifting the wonderful students, these young scholars who hopefully will be taking all of our positions in time, for uplifting these wonderful community, faculty, staff, student members who are doing the hard work and the heavy lifting of moving us forward. It's been my pleasure to serve as your MC. Have a wonderful rest of the day. It's a good one.